Can I say what a pleasure it is to welcome Prime Minister Odinga here to London, to have had talks with him and his ministers that are part of the National Unity Government, and let me send my best wishes for the health of President Kibaki, who couldn't be here today. You know, only 6 months ago, Kenya stood on the brink of civil war. Kenya's friends watched with fear as ethnic violence and insecurity gripped the country. But Kenya stepped away from the brink due to the leadership of President Kibaki and Prime Minister Odinga, partly due to the mediation efforts, of course, of Kofi Annan, partly due to strong international support for reconciliation, but most of all because the Kenyan people turned their backs on violence and chose to work together. And I want to say today, as I did 6 months ago, that Britain will stand by Kenya as it opens a new chapter in its history. We welcome the government's commitment to power sharing. We welcome the strenuous efforts made by all sides to live up to the expectations of the Kenyan people. We will fulfill our promise to help with the rebuilding of Kenya. And to this end, I'm delighted that Britain is today hosting a business roundtable which will send the clearest signal that Kenya is open for business. Neither we nor the Kenyan government underestimate the challenges. Whether it is action against corruption or other action, it is vital to attract investment and improve economic growth. But I'm convinced by my talks today that Kenya's leaders have the will and determination to take all the steps necessary, and I applaud their commitment. Britain will continue to stand by them. And I believe our partnership between our two countries is stronger than ever. We're working together to counter drugs trafficking and terrorism. We are both working to ensure the trade round is successful. Just underway in Geneva, we hope it will yield a breakthrough, and Minister Kenyatta is here, who's part of the talks that will bring hope to millions in the developing world. The coming days will be critical. This is a moment of opportunity that, if gone, will not come back easily. The time for just debating is over. We must now do this trade deal. We're also supporting the creation of an East African standby brigade to promote peace in the region. And we share a determination to uphold democratic rights in Africa, starting with Zimbabwe. The signing of an agreement this week between Zimbabwe's leaders is a welcome step forward. But it must be matched by an end to violence against the MDC, full humanitarian access for NGOs so that those who are suffering from famine can be helped. And any transitional government must represent the will of the people, as demonstrated so clearly at the end of March. In the meantime, we will continue to take action and support sanctions against those who are responsible for the violence, as the European Union did yesterday, expanding sanctions against the regime. Prime Minister Odinga recognizes more clearly than most both the importance of democracy's march through Africa and the dangers should democracy fail. I'm delighted to welcome him to London as a friend, to welcome his ministers who are participating together in the National Unity Government. This is a new generation of African leaders who are ready to build a successful future for all Africa's people. Prime Minister Odinga.
Thank you very much, Gordon. I am very delighted to be here in London this morning. We arrived yesterday at the invitation of the Prime Minister, Gordon Brown. I'm bringing with me greetings from the President of Kenya, President Mwai Kibaki. I would like to pay tribute to the Right Honorable Gordon Brown, the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, for the support that he and his government gave to us during the crisis in our country. Unknown to very many people, it was Prime Minister Gordon Brown who started off the process of negotiations through phone calls, one to me and the other one to President Kibaki, during which he urged us to agree that he could play a role behind the scenes to broker negotiations. That phone call is what started it all off, ending up with the establishment of a panel of eminent persons led by the former UN Secretary General, Dr. Kofi Annan. That panel presided over the negotiations that ended up with the signing of the peace accord in our country. And thereafter, it was followed by the formation of a grand coalition government. this coalition government is a shared government on a 50-50 basis between my party, the Orange Democratic Movement, and President Kibaki's party of national unity. This is an experiment in Africa, the first time that such a grand coalition government has been formed on the African continent. It's therefore a pioneering experiment. We are determined to make it work for the sake of the African continent. We have embarked in the process of reconstruction following the crisis. In this, we require quite a bit of resources, and we have actually made an appeal to our friends and development partners to assist us. We know that during the crisis, over 1,500 people lost their lives. 350,000 or more people were displaced. Resettlement of these people has posed a challenge to the government. I am happy to note that we have resettled quite a number, but there are still others who still require to be resettled. Then we have the issues of Millennium Development Goals to achieve. We have made progress, appreciable progress in the field of education, in the field of health, through the support of our friends like the government of the United Kingdom. We would still require more support in this area. And this is one of the issues that we have discussed with the Prime Minister and his team. We would like to expand agricultural production so that we become self-sufficient in food production. At the moment, because of the international food shortage, we are also experiencing for the first time a crisis in our country. We have to import a very substantial amount of our staple food, which is maize, from South Africa. We need 3 million bags, which requires a lot of money. We have come to the UK with one message, that Kenya, after the crisis, is once again up and kicking. That this is a new Kenya, a Kenya that is not coming with a begging basket, but it is saying we want only two things, trade and investment. We want to attract foreign direct investment in our country. This delegation includes several businessmen from Kenya who will be able this afternoon to interact with their counterpart in the UK and to tell them what has been done since the crisis started. We want to make Kenya one of the most attractive investment destinations in the world. We are trying to remove most of those obstacles which have scared investors in our country. We are dealing with bureaucracy and red tape. We are dealing with the issue of corruption. We are dealing with the issue of infrastructure. And this is one area where we need investments. We're trying to create the public-private partnerships, even in infrastructure, so that we can open up the country to investments. And then we are also dealing with the issue of insecurity in our country. We hope that this, to combine together, will make Kenya a very attractive investment destination. On the issue of Zimbabwe, we are on the same page. We do believe that the people of Zimbabwe deserve a better treatment. We believe the people of Zimbabwe have been cheated of their will, that they voted for change in Zimbabwe, but they have not received change because of a regime that has refused to respect the will of the people. The negotiations that started the day before yesterday are welcome. We welcome them, and if they are conducted on the basis that there was an election on the 29th of March that produced some results that need to be respected. We know that there may be need to find an peaceful, decent exit for President Mugabe in Zimbabwe. But we think that the international community needs to continue to stand firm behind the people of Zimbabwe so that a peaceful settlement is found. We are equally concerned about the development in Darfur. We'd like to see that the Darfur issue is brought to a speedy conclusion. Here, the African Union must take the lead to press for a speedy resolution of the issue of Darfur. With regard to the world trade negotiations, again, we are on the same page. Kenyan delegation is attending the negotiations right now in Geneva. In fact, our minister, Deputy Prime Minister, has been elected the chair of the African group. We will work together in these negotiations so that we can be able to come up with a new order that will meet the needs of the people of the world. I thank you very much. I want to conclude by thanking the former High Commissioner to Nairobi, Mr. Adam Wood, who was representing the government of the United Kingdom in Kenya during this crisis, for the very positive role that he played in helping us to find a solution. I thank you very much, Mr. Prime Minister.
Thank you very much.